Well, Dad, if you're going to start using tonight, how are you supposed to go running tomorrow?
Today is September 1st, Saturday, and I'm planning to take a picture of North America Nebula. North America Nebula is in the constellation of Cygnus. Cygnus is a very dynamic region. It's like a New York City of our Milky Way. It has like close to 10 supernova remnants. It has 14 pulsar binary systems. Very interesting place for astronomers to study in detail. It has a Pelican Nebula right around that North America Nebula. And if you put like 4 full moons together, the area is almost equal to that in the sky that it covers. I'm planning to use the spaceship looking guide scope as well. This is just for my guiding. This is actually the telescope that I'm planning to. And this is monochrome. I'm using filter slider. I'll show you my workflow. All right, let's get to work. If you want a good picture, you need to have a good polar alignment. I used Sharp Cap to polar align. Okay, so finally in Sequence Generator Pro, I took the H alpha red, green and blue. H alpha I took 16 seconds for 1 hour, and red I took 5 seconds. I think I took 200 pictures of each one of them. And on the green, I took almost the same amount, like 5 seconds and 200 pics, and blue the same as well. Once I got these 4, I tried to combine them, like I extracted into the red, green and blue channels. I did the star alignment. Once the star alignment is done, here is it took a little while to process this picture. If you see, this is the original picture. This is the H alpha image. It came out pretty good, actually. The hydrogen alpha, if you look at the red filter came out like this. So if you compare hydrogen alpha with red, you know why people rave about taking pictures in narrow band. There's a big signal difference between these two pictures. This one looks much sharper, much more crispier. Anyway, so once I combined these, here is the picture I got. So once I extracted the background and stuff, I got this kind of a picture. This looks okay. I did an ABE on it, and of course this is the star alignment. Once that is done, once the it is star aligned now again with the H alpha and RGB this time gave me a rotation like this. So from what I understand, I need to pay attention to the degrees of rotation, the image I'm taking on each one of these channels. I think that's critical. Anyway, that's a lesson from this side. But once I took this file, I was able to do a dynamic crop and then removed the angle on it and then made the picture into decent enough picture. But you see a lot of green background on it, and you see this is actually the North America shape. This is Gulf of Mexico, and this is the Pelican, right? So, and then I processed these by copying it into a clone, and I did another ABE on it. So once I completed it, here is the version after the ABE. There is one additional thing that I did here is I did a photometric color calibration. So this one took a little while. It downloaded from the Harvard server and then basically did a pretty good color calibration. I really liked it. I couldn't do this myself with any other way. So once the color calibration is done, I went and did a multi-scale linear transformation. So basically this is to reduce the noise in the back. So this is the picture after reducing the noise. And I did a little curves transformation, put a little bit of S-curve. But anyway, once that is done, here is the kind of a final picture. I did a little bit of rotation so that it shows up. I can further rotate it, but I think this looks pretty good. I did a histogram transformation and moved, slided a little bit so that you can see a little bit better view of this picture. Yeah, the shadows are there now. So here is my final picture. I hope you guys like it. Thanks for watching.